is on the order of operations. The order of operations is basically a roadmap or basically our framework for how to solve any mathematical questions. So I'm going to talk to you a little bit about PEMA, which is how I would like you to remember the order of operations, and I'm going to also talk to you about a little acronym to help you remember. So the first thing that we're going to do is parentheses, and parentheses means any operation that is in parentheses. So for instance, 2 plus 5 within the parentheses would mean add 2 and 5 first and then multiply it by the 8 on the outside. Whereas if I had something like 3 times 5, this is not considered parentheses because there's not an operation that's happening inside the parentheses. You might also end up with brackets, and brackets are parentheses that are around other parentheses. So I might end up with something like this, where I have 9 plus and then a bracket, which means I would start with the parentheses on the inside and then the brackets, which are parentheses around parentheses. So you start in and work your way out. Last thing about parentheses is if you end up with a division bar, you treat it as parentheses also. So if I had, say, 4 plus 2 over 9 minus 7, I would go ahead and pretend there were parentheses around this. So I would add the 4 and the 2, and then I would subtract the 9 and the 7, and then I could go ahead and do division. So 6 divided by 2 would be 3. So it's important that division is treated as parentheses also. After you clear the parentheses that you can, and within the parentheses you're going to be following all of this order of operations as well, then you're going to worry about your exponents. So if you have exponents, which means something to a specific power, you're going to go ahead and evaluate that. If it's exponents on parentheses, again, you would go ahead and evaluate the parentheses first and then do the exponents. Then you're going to do all multiplication and division in one step from left to right. So it might take you 2 steps, 3 steps, depending on what you have going on, but multiplication and division go from left to right. So what I don't want you to do is go ahead and do all the multiplication and then do all of the division, because that would be incorrect. And the last one is addition and subtraction from left to right. And once you're done with that, you should be done with all of the operations within the question. Now, many of you have probably heard the acronym, Please Excuse My Dear Aunt Sally. This is something from way back in probably grade school. This is great to remember as well. The reason that I didn't write PEMDAS or PEMDAS is I really don't want multiplication and division to happen separately. So I don't want you to do all the multiplication, then all the division, and then all the addition and all subtraction. So it's important to understand that M and D are together and A and S are together. But if Please Excuse My Dear Aunt Sally helps you to remember those steps, that's just fine with me. So let's do a couple of practice together and see how we do. In this question, there are no parentheses and there are no exponents. So I'm going to go multiplication, division from left to right. So I see that I have 12 divided by 2, and I can divide that to get 6. And because it's separated by a subtraction sign, I can actually do the 4 times 2 on the same step. So I did division and I did multiplication. 4 times 2 is 8. So now I've got only addition or subtraction left. In this case, it is subtraction. So 6 minus 8, or keep, flip, change to get 6 plus negative 8. My answer is negative 2. For my second question, again, this is a division question, so I'm going to pretend there are parentheses on the top and on the bottom and go from there. So 2 plus 6, I can go ahead and add those to get 8. On the bottom, I've got a little more going on, so I've got 16 minus 4 times 3. So on the bottom, multiplication and division should happen before the subtraction. So this is going to be 16 minus 12. So again, I can't divide this yet because this is still implied parentheses on the bottom. So on the top, I still have 8. On the bottom, I have 16 minus 12, which is 4. And now that I have just a value on the top and the bottom, I can divide. 8 divided by 4 is 2, and that's my final answer. Here is a much longer question. So now I've got some square roots and some exponents and all sorts of fun stuff. So going from left to right, I'm first going to focus on parentheses. So I'm going to leave this 10 out here. So it's important that you just keep rewriting things that you haven't dealt with yet. Otherwise, you forget about them. So I've got the 10 on the outside. I've got 2 minus 4. And notice I'm stopping here because now I have a parenthesis and I can evaluate my parenthesis, 6 minus 8. which is negative 2. Again, you can keep flip change to remember to do that. I'm going to leave that exponent on the outside. And it's kind of a judgment call on this one. I can, because this is separate from everything else, it's got its own brackets. I'm going to go ahead and take 16 minus 7 to get 9. And it doesn't affect anything because it's not in here with the rest of these parentheses. Next up, I still can't deal with the 10 because I've got this whole mess of stuff in the parentheses. So now within the parentheses, I'm going to continue working. I've got 2. I can't take 2 minus 4 yet because I haven't yet multiplied 4 times negative 2. So I've got 2 minus 4 times negative 2 is negative 8. And again, because this radical 9 is on the outside, I'm going to go ahead and deal with it. So the square root of 9 is 3. On my next step, I still haven't finished dealing with everything in here, so I'm going to keep, flip, change. So I'm going to take 2 plus 8, which is 10. And now I'm going to write that as 10 squared. And so, excuse me. So now I'm pretty much done with parentheses. Now I'm going to look at exponents. So I have 10 squared. 10 squared is 100. And now there's no multiplication division, so I'm just going to go addition, subtraction from left to right. So 10 minus 100, or plus negative 100, is negative 90. Negative 90 plus 3 is negative 87. Let's try another one. Now we've got some absolute value happening in here as well. When you have an absolute value, go ahead and think of it as parentheses. So here I've got negative and then 5 minus 7. 5 minus 7 is negative 2. Still inside the absolute value until I've dealt with the absolute value. On the bottom, because it's separate, remember I'm doing all of this. Because it's separate, I'm going to go ahead and take negative 1 minus 2 or plus negative 2. So on the bottom, I have negative 3 squared. And now I'm going to go ahead and keep simplifying before I can do any division here. So I'm going to go ahead and simplify the top. In the top, I've got the absolute value of negative 2, which is positive 2. But remember, this negative on the outside says, okay, keep a negative on it. So it's the opposite of the absolute value of negative 2. And plus 11. On the bottom, negative 3 squared is negative 3 times negative 3, which is positive 9. On the top, I have negative 2 plus 11, which is positive 9. On the bottom, I have positive 9. When I divide 9 by 9, I get 1, and that's my answer. Go ahead and try these, and then press play and see how you did. For this question, I'm going to first evaluate whatever is in the parentheses. So I'm going to take 42 minus 13. I'm not going to worry about that 4 yet. I'm going to keep that on the outside. So 42 minus 13 is 29. I'm going to need my calculator because I can't do 29 to the 4th in my head. Woo! So I get 4 plus 707,281 minus 3. I'm going to go ahead and add 4 to that. So 707,285 minus 3, and then I'm going to subtract the 3, so 707,282 should be my final answer there. Next one. Oops, okay. Next one, I've got some serious fractions going on. So on the top, I'm going to just start plugging away. This one's going to take us a little while. So I've got 4 on the outside, and then I have a bracket, and you don't need to write that multiplication sign because it's implied if it's right next to a parenthesis. So I've got 3 plus 2, and then I'm going to go ahead and take 8 minus 6, which is 2. And that's all I can do for the first step, so I'm going to keep going. On the bottom, I've got the 5 on the outside, and then I've got 14 minus 2, and then parenthesis 2 plus 3, which is 5. Now, I want to point out a common error that students make. A lot of students take 3 plus 2 first to get 5 and then multiply it by 2. Resist the temptation to do that because you have to do all multiplication division before you do that addition right here. So my next step is on the top. I've got a 4 on the outside. I've got a 2 times 2 over here, so I can't deal with the 3 plus yet, but I can take 2 times 2 to get 4. And on the bottom, I've got the 5 on the outside, and then 14, and then 2 times 5 is multiplication, so times 10. So now on the top, I've got 4 times 3 plus 4, which is 4 times 7. On the bottom, I have 5 times 14 minus 10, so 5 times 4. And then you could cancel these 4s here. I'm going to go ahead and multiply it out. Most people wouldn't see that 4 right away. So I'm going to go ahead and multiply to get 28 over 20. And they're both even. And in fact, they're not just even, but 4 goes into both of them. So I'm going to divide by 4 to get 7 over 5. And I can leave it as 7 fifths, or I can turn that into 1 and 2 fifths. So pay attention to whatever type of answer that your text or your program is looking for.